One fine rainy evening, I was all set with tea and snacks to enjoy the most beautiful weather of the year. Rain somewhat gives a kind of peace and makes things look beautiful. Teacup in my hand, and I was looking outside and observing the clear crystals falling down from the sky. The taste of the tea was adding some more essence to it. I suddenly heard Mom calling out my name. My process of thoughts were disturbed, and I ran downstairs to find out if everything was all right. When I reached there, I saw my mom standing outside the main entrance and her face showing the expression of panicness. I looked here and there and tried to spot out the reason of her concern, but I failed to. Then she pointed outside the gate and said, "Look at her." It took me some few seconds to mark out the thing she was trying to show me. I could see the heavy rain and some red blood flowing with the water and changing the water into red. Mom said she's dead. She might have met with an accident. But I suddenly saw her legs moving. I was happy that the thread of her life was yet not completely broken. I wanted to save her. I ran to call Papa so that he can do something. In the meanwhile, in front of my eyes, another car ran over. She flipped and fell down. Her heartbeat stopped. No ambulance, no police, no one cared because she was just a poor cat. The cruel world never cared about the one who could not fight for her rights. Maybe no one cared because a cat cannot speak, or her family cannot file a case against anyone, or maybe no one cared because she was just a cat, a poor cat. I stood there and mentally cursed the car driver, and she was lying still there on the mid of the road in heavy rain. I saw her whole evening lying there, and I was feeling restless because I could not help her. I could not save her. Her life ended. That night while sleeping, I prayed God and said, "Please God, never make me face such situation where I cannot help someone. Never make me that helpless that I cannot do anything. When I see someone end up, if I cannot help someone, then I have no rights to see someone suffer." With that, I went to sleep. Next morning, before I was awake, the cat was taken away. This was a small incident, but it taught me a great thing about this human society.